How's it going, everybody? So today I would like to show you a really interesting fish behavior I observed during a night dive on Negros Island in the Philippines. So this is a juvenile filefish. I believe it's a juvenile of Paramonacanthus, and the current or the surge during the time when I filmed the fish was not terrible, but it was significant. So you can see that seaweed and that tree leaf, which the fish is next to, is moving around. And this very small fish is using its mouth to hold on to that vegetation or to that piece of tree which had been swept into the ocean. And it's holding on to that in order to stay in place. So this is a really clever type of strategy in order to remain near its territory, which might be probably its feeding territory, or there might be hiding places for it. So this is a close-up. So when we approached the fish, it switched, you could see that before, from the blade of seaweed to that tree leaf. And it's actually not holding onto the leaf itself, but it's holding onto some algae which are growing on that leaf. So very interesting way of staying in place. It's almost as if it's using its mouth like a hand. So this is what a scuba diver person would do. If there's a very strong current, the person would hold on to things, obviously, with their hands. And this is something I had not observed for the first time, but I had previously observed that in Australia 8 years ago, and this was a different type of filefish. So you can see the image here. This type of filefish is called a leather jacket in Australia, but it's a related species. At that point, I was mostly taking still photographs. I was not filming, and this filefish is holding on to a tunicate, to an invertebrate, but same strategy, quite clever. And there's actually a scientific paper, and this is an observation from the Red Sea, where yet another species of filefish is holding on to invertebrates at night, same strategy to remain in place. So a rather universal type of behavior among these filefishes, it seems. Quite stunning. Now, the other thing which we observed during that dive is this very rare garnet lionfish. So the conventional lionfish, the Pterois volitans, is quite abundant in the Pacific, where it's at home, not invasive. But this is a rare species, and you know, what a beautiful fish. You can see the pectoral fins and these beautiful blue spots. So I was quite excited to see that one. Again, this was at night, so you can see all these tiny shrimp zapping around. And I'm going to conclude the video with footage of a conventional lionfish. I believe this is the Pterois volitans, and this is a small juvenile. So, as usual, I hope you enjoyed this. Like, subscribe, ask questions in the comments. You can support the channel by PayPal, and see you next week.